Hi everyone, I hope you're doing well. It's Miss Fogarty here. I have really enjoyed being able to talk to a lot of you over the past few days and make sure that we have a plan in place so that you are still learning and being successful while we are doing this distance learning. So today, if that's you, you feel free to call me or text me so that we can make a plan to help you be successful even when we're not in person together. Today, we are going to work on Module 5, Lesson 12, and we're going to be using rulers to measure fractional side lengths of rectangles, and then we're going to find the area. So the first set of directions says, measure the rectangle to the nearest 1/4 inch with your ruler and label the dimensions. The dimensions will be the length and the width, then find the area. When we measure something to the nearest 1/4 inch, that means every 1/4 inch that's going to be a mark. So if we start at 0 inches and let's go to 1 inch, we're going to go every 4 inch, let's make a mark. If you notice on a ruler, there are 3 places in between each inch where the line is a little bit longer. This first one represents 1/4. Think about quarters, 1/4, 2/4, or I could reduce that to 1/2. And then this next longer line is going to be 3/4. And then 1. So whenever you are going to be measuring today, make sure you're measuring to the nearest 1/4 inch, which means either to the 1/4 inch, 1/2, 3/4, or whole inch. So I have my ruler here and I have a rectangle that I'm going to measure to the nearest 1/4 inch. An advice that I have for you is making sure that whenever you're going to measure a line that you always start at the 0 tick mark on the ruler, not the end of the ruler. This does not count for our measurement. We have to start at this line where 0 begins. So let's measure the length. Okay, well, I'm starting right at 0. Even though this is the end of my ruler, I'm starting right at 0. And I'm going. Okay, it's a little bit more than 2. It's not quite to 3. And I see this would be 1/4, 2/4, or 1/2, and 3/4. So it's closest to the 3/4 tick mark. So that will be 2 3/4 inches long. Let's measure the width. Again, I'm not going to start at the end of my ruler. I'm going to start right at 0. 0, okay, it's past 1, so it's going to be a little bit more than 1. And now I'm looking for my tick marks. I see my first tick mark, which would be 1/4, 2/4, which would be 1/2. So this is a length of 1 1/2 inches. Now I'm going to find the area of this rectangle. So I want to find how much space it's taking up. I'm going to say, okay, well, I remember area is length times width. So I'm going to take my length, which is 2 3/4, and my width, which is 1 1/2. This is exactly what we've been doing the past 2 days. If I see a mixed number, step one, my advice for you is that we turn this into an improper fraction. I'm going to say 4 times 2 gives me 8, and 8 plus 3 gives me 11. I keep my denominator the same. I'm going to do the same thing over here. 2 times 1 is 2, plus 1 is 3. When I multiply fractions, I multiply straight across, so I get 33/8. This is not my answer yet. That's as an improper fraction, but my 8 can go into my numerator. So I'm going to count by 8s. 8, 16, 24, 32. Okay, so it can go in 4 times, 32, 33. I just have 1 extra to get to 33, and my denominator stays the same. So my area is 4 1/8 inches squared, since I'm doing inches times inches. Example 2. Sebastian wants to draw a picture with a living room and a kitchen. The living room will have dimensions of 2 1/2 inches by 1 1/2 inches. And the kitchen will have dimensions of 1 3/4 inches by 3 inches. What will the total area of the living room and kitchen be? That's my question. It says, draw a picture. I'm going to start out by labeling. Okay, well, I know I'm going to have a living room, and I know I'm going to have a kitchen. Once I figure out the area of those two, I need to solve for the total area, just like we did last week, of the living room plus and the kitchen. So then I'll be able to find my total area. I took the dimensions and drew the rectangle with my ruler for the living room, and I took the dimensions for the kitchen and I drew the rectangle here. I need to find the area of both of these, so I'm going to do length times width and length times width. Your job is to find the area of each of these rooms and then to find the total, you'll add them together. On the next slide, write this answer that you get for the total area and see if you get it right.